First of all, I point out that quantum electrodynamics was first set up in the form of the quantum theory of Maxwell's electromagnetic field by Paul Dirac, and what he was doing was providing the theoretical framework for what in Einstein's work in 1905 was a rather brilliant idea, which simply didn't fit in with the previous classical ideas at all. Later on, the quantum electrodynamics as the quantum theory of interacting photons and electrons became the first very successful quantum field theory in the sense that it made extremely accurate predictions. That didn't happen until around 1950, and previously it had gone through a rather difficult period where people didn't understand how to handle infinite quantities, which occurred in the formalism. We'll be coming back to infinite quantities in the context of other interactions later in this series. The other point I would pick up is the matter of symmetries. The importance of symmetries in classical mechanics has already been referred to in the first week. However, that's very late development in classical mechanics. The connection between symmetries and conservation laws didn't really get properly formalized till the work of Emmy Noether in the early 20th century. But from the point of view of these lectures, the relation between symmetries and conservation laws is a very important idea.